Welcome to online classes. Today we are going to start our third chapter and the name of the chapter is Nouns Number. Okay, so students, we know that nouns we can count. We can say a single noun or we can say two nouns. We can count it that they are more in numbers. Okay, so there are nouns. It can be divided into two numbers. One is called singular and other is plural. Okay, so singular means those which refers to only one. Okay, when we are talking about one, that is known as singular. For example, cat, dog, girl, fan, these are your singular because they are one in number. Okay, so when a person, a place or a thing, it stands one in number, it is known as singular. Okay, next, plural. It refers to more than one. When we have more than one, okay, like 2, 3, 4, 10, 100, we have more than one. Like the person, when the place, when the thing, it is more than one, then we call it as plural nouns. Okay, like cats, so many cats, dogs, girls, fans, etc. So these are your plural nouns. Okay, in Hindi you have studied ekvachan and bahuvachan. So it is same. Singular noun means ekvachan and plural noun means bahuvachan. Okay, so singular noun, it stands for one person, one place, one animal or one thing. And similarly, plural noun, it stands for more than one person's, places, animals or things. Understood? So I think you have understood singular noun and plural noun now. Okay, singular noun that refers to one and plural noun refers to more than one. For example, in singular noun we will have cat, and plural, when cat, more than one cat, we will say cats. Same way, singular dog, when there is one dog we will say dog, but more than one dog we will say dogs. Girl, one girl we will say girl, more than one we will say girls. Fan, singular fan, but when it is more than singular, it is plural, then we will say fans. Okay, now students, when we are using these nouns, singular and plural nouns, in a sentence, okay, one thing we have to remember, that is verb. So the verb, it also changes. For example, see here, I have written one example. The student studies in the class. Okay, the student studies in the class. So here student, it is singular. So with singular, the verb, it has s. Okay, so it is also singular noun, we will use singular verb, and singular verb, it has s in it. Okay, same way when I am saying the students study in the class, so you can see here the verb, it is changing. Okay, here noun is singular, so verb, it has s. Here noun is plural, so verb, it does not has s. Okay, so when the noun is changing,